It's happening. The signs of the last days prophecies are happening, just like the Bible said. Events and conditions happening in the world are connecting to the biblical prophecies as signs of the last days, showing we are nearing the end of this age as we watch and pray for the coming of Jesus. But now, Russia is threatening Israel's homeland over Israel's latest provocative and daring air raid into Syria from Lebanon on Christmas Day 2018, because Russia is changing the rules of engagement in Syria for Israel. And it looks as if Russia and Israel could be heading for a showdown over Israel's attacks into Syria at the Iranians. The Israeli Defense Forces, they made a daring raid into Syria where, according to sources from inside the region, a wide-ranging IDF attack took place southwest of Damascus, hitting Iranian and Hezbollah targets, with some of them embedded in Syrian bases. And the missiles were launched by the Israeli planes from inside Lebanese airspace, reportedly with two waves of aircraft. The first wave were F-16 jets, which failed to connect with their targets. Then it's reported the IDF persisted and sent F-35 stealth planes over in a second wave. But Syria is said to have countered the attack with the Russian S-200 air defense weapons, which, depending on reports, seem to have had some success against the attack. Additionally, it was reported that Syria, in retaliation, also fired an SA-5 missile into Israel's homeland. In a furious response to Israel's air offensive, the Russian Defense Ministry again accused Israel of provocative actions, they said, when launching the missile strike on Syrian territory from the airspace of neighboring Lebanon, and again accused Israel of endangering civilian passenger aircraft. And according to Russian generals, the Israeli attack on Syria was again carried out under cover of civilian aircraft landing at the airports of Beirut and Damascus. Also, Lebanon's transport minister also said that two civilian airplanes in Lebanese airspace narrowly avoided the Israeli warplanes, he said, averting a human catastrophe. And they are filing complaints with the UN against Israel. The Russians said the Syrian military did not fully engage all of its air defense systems, so they were trying to avoid accidentally hitting the passenger jets. Now, these events again highlight the increasingly tense relations between Israel and Russia, which have grown strained since the September downing of a Russian plane last year by Syrian forces, who were also responding to another previous similar Israeli raid. And Russia blamed Israel for the downing of that plane, killing all aboard, because they say the Israeli jets were using it for cover. Now, after that is when Russia sent Syria more sophisticated aircraft, anti-aircraft and anti-missile technology. That was the S-300, which The Syrians and the Russians in Syria do not have the S-300 totally set up yet, but it's being reported that probably by the end of January or the 1st of February, they'll have those active. But against this latest Israeli attack, they use the S-200, but they do have the S-300s and are getting those ready. And whenever Russia sent that new anti-aircraft and sophisticated anti-missile technology to Syria, that was a direct move against Israel, which thereafter Israel had not done any more air raids into Syria until now with this Christmas air raid, and after the U.S. announced that it was leaving Syria. But now it's reported that Russia, angry over this latest air raid by Israel into Syria, has made another direct threat against Israel, saying that if there are any more airstrikes by Israel into Syria, then Syria will, in retaliation, also fire missiles deep into Israel's homeland. And it was reported in Israel's latest air raid that Syria, in retaliation, did fire an SA-5 missile, which is a renamed Russia S-200, and they fired it deep into Israel, and it shook several towns on impact, but thankfully exploded harmlessly in an unpopulated part of Mount Carmel, as again, the Lord God protected Israel. But Israel's air defense system missed that incoming missile. By issuing this threat, Moscow confirmed that the Syrian missile was aimed deliberately at the Israeli heartland and was not astray from the attacks on Israeli aircraft, as some have thought. If the Russians and Syrians were to carry out this threat of payback for any more Israeli airstrikes over Syria in the future, it would put a huge area of Israel and its population at risk. And these missiles now supplied to Syria by Russia are in batteries that can fire multiple missiles that could bring serious devastation to Israeli towns. The Syrian SA-5 is actually the Russian S-200, which is older, but still has a very long range with medium to high altitude surface-to-air capacity and can also function in all weather and can be used to hit ground targets as well as aircraft and missiles. But sources say that the Russians, in changing the rules of engagement in Syria for Israel, also still indicated that Syria would not unilaterally launch a surface missile offensive against Israel, but would employ a tit-for-tat strategy, countering Israeli airstrikes over Syrian airspace with missile attacks into Israeli airspace. This could be taken as a Russian message to Israel that the Kremlin and Russian army chiefs are now weighing their options for beginning to retaliate against Israel for air attacks into Syria, which shows Russia's relations with Israel are growing increasingly tense to borderline hostile. Russia wants to make it to where Israel will find it too risky for air raids into Syria, and they want Israel to accept Russia as the guarantor of Israel's safety. But Israel's Prime Minister Netanyahu, in response to this threat by Russia, still said this: "Our actions against Iran's military establishment in Syria will continue." And he went on to say that we stand by our red lines. These events and conditions show that Israel and Russia, as the prophecies foretell, are inextricably set upon a course for an unavoidable showdown that can result in fulfillment of the biblical prophecy foretold over 2,500 years ago by God's prophet Ezekiel in chapter 38. These events are connecting to the last day's prophecies as signs, showing we are nearing the end of this age for the world, and the fulfillment of prophecy, and the catching away of the true church unto Jesus Christ. For an unbelieving world, it will be the end time. But for the believers of Jesus Christ, biblically born again spiritually into the kingdom of God, it is not the end, but the beginning of a wonderful new future in Jesus Christ forever. Signs of the Last Days ministry connects the conditions and events happening in the world to the biblical prophecies. We are now reaching into cities and areas all across the United States, and the Lord has blessed us to reach into over 40 countries now around the world. And what makes this all possible is the support from the Lord and His body of Christ in the world is you, who give to God and to this ministry, so to bring all these broadcasts and content to bless you and others. The Bible says we live in perilous times of the last days, where the world is selfish as lovers of themselves and lovers of money, despising those doing good for God. But we have not so learned Christ. For Jesus said in Luke 6, to give, and it will be given to you, giving us His principle of giving as God's way of supporting His work of ministry, and in turn blessing His people with a greater blessing as they do so. Pray about going to the website, signsofthelastdays.org, and there securely give an offering of any amount that's tax deductible, and be a partner in prophecy, helping this ministry proclaim more signs of the last day's prophecies so more people know to get ready for the coming of Jesus. Thank you for supporting this last day's ministry, and receive the blessing of the Lord Jesus upon you as you help others to watch and pray and prepare for the kingdom of our Lord Jesus Christ, of which there shall be no end.